Don't you harm a single hair on her head, or I'll use every technique I know to cut your miserable carcass to pieces.
Welcome back, my loyal subjects, to more Trails in the Sky. Pharaoh Fiasco here, and last episode we left off, you'll remember that we were getting demolished by Fango, Bronco and Fango. Joshua got hit twice and didn't die. Okay, so we spent a lot of Mira upgrading everybody's equipment, and also we got some more CP on everybody. So I'm gonna attribute all of that money we just spent to Joshua not dying right there. He is gonna rockfish skewer himself. Estelle is gonna flare arrow the one weak against arts. And Kloe is gonna camp for one of them. Yeah. Let's focus our attacks on one person for right now, on one enemy for the moment. Yeah. Oh, crap. Joshua is gonna... Joshua Bolatier. And then we're gonna have him open up with his weak against physical attacks. Has extremely high offensive skills, but is weak against arts. I wonder if that means that he's not gonna take a lot of damage from this. Hopefully that's not the case. 465 is kind of okay. Crap. 399, dude. Kloe needs to Tira. Yeah, one of these is gonna suffice. Or can we get a La Tira in? Nope, that'll move us back really far, and it won't get her anyways. Alright. I probably should have just had her use her, S-Craft there, but... Crap, Joshua died. Once we kill this one, it should be smoother sailing. If it starts looking like Chloe's not gonna get another turn, then we'll have her use her S-Craft, but... Oh, cool. Okay, Kloe is gonna Azalea Rose Joshua. Learn recipe for Azalea Rose. And then she is actually gonna S-Craft to keep us in this fight. Whoa. Okay, I'm not sure if that was just on my screen or what. Oh well. I thought that gave us a defense buff too. Oh, we have to use it at 200, right. Next, we are gonna... Yeah, we should pretty much just try to kill this thing. Hey. Our turn's not gonna come for a bit anyway, so... 294. Well, Chloe's dead. But it's fine. Because we've got the Shadow Spear, and we're gonna kill, be able to kill this one. Oh, or maybe not. Come on, Flare Arrow. Yes, there we go. I don't know if that's Fango or Bronco. Death Throws! Oh, defense and agility up. Awesome. I bought more Azalea Roses, too. They're too good. Estelle, to counteract that, we're gonna have her use morale. We're gonna have her not use morale. Let's see. This is the one that's weak against physical attacks, right? But it's weak against physical attacks. Crap. That one was the worst one to, like, use. And it's just its defense and agility. Let's, move plus one. Crap. Okay, we're going to have Estelle run up and attack. Always the best plan of action. Crap, dude. Joshua's gonna heal himself with coffee ice cream. Okay, we should be in there now. No real chance for us to lose this going forward. We can't use Camphor. Let's tier a Joshua. Just to keep him out of the death range. And then Estelle. Attack! And with Estelle doing that much damage with a basic attack, that's crazy. Let's go out on a limb. We'll have Joshua dual strike. You've got to be kidding me, dude. Joshua. Well. Oh, freaking well, Joshua. Kloe got a new weapon, too. In retrospect... Oh, crap! Art. Or item, rather. Let's get another Zalia Rose down his throat. Oh, not close enough. Okay, so I know what we're gonna do. This, and then this. And then he can take his turn. 633. Okay. Kloe is close enough, though, to Azalea Rose. Oh, we might as well use a Reviving Balm since we've got it. If he turns around and attacks Joshua, this will have been a horribly bad idea. And he's turning around and attacking Joshua, it was a horribly bad idea. Is that defense and agility buff never going away or something? Okay, another Reviving Bomb. Let's go. Come on, Joshua. Stand up and stay up. We have to kill these mutts. Someone else. Oh, crap, dude. And he gets a second attack just for good measure. That's good. I like that. I really don't like that, but I'll say I will. I'll say I do, rather. Okay, we're gonna say F it to the Reviving Bombs. Joshua is gonna get healed with an Azalea Rose. There we go. Back in range, everybody. Okay. Whew, now he can't be killed instantly. The double attack. All right, Joshua. Let's see what you've got now. 249. Estelle is gonna pummel, actually. Yeah, we'll crit him, so might as well. 904! Death throws. You have no one to death throws, though, so it doesn't matter. Cool. Nothing? Joshua didn't learn anything? Okay, that's fine. That's cool. It can't be! My sweet babies! How could you do this? You're one to talk. Let me readjust this real quick. There we go. In accordance with Bracer Guild protocol, and this time with authority, we're placing you under arrest. Surrender and you will not be harmed. You leave me no choice but to use my trump card. What else could this dude have under his sleeve, I ask you? Huh? Is that a wand? Or like, a wand? It was a wand, huh? Time stop. What in the world? I can't move! Okay, there we go.
Did he use an orbital art?
No! This has to be an artifact!
So what the hell is that?
Well, well, your knowledge is impressive, Ms. Renz. This is the Kronos Rod, an artifact which happens to be a family heirloom.
Oh, so the same thing a certain character in Trails of Cold Steel had access to.
Oh, okay. Huh.
It can completely paralyze anyone within range in the blink of an eye.
That's crazy!
How does the Church not know about such a powerful artifact? With a tool crafted by the wise agents themselves, what else would one expect? Tactical ornaments can't even begin to compare to this. Sadly, it only has that one function.
Whoa! Which means I'll have to sully my hands and dispose of you myself.
You know, Delmore, I'll give it to you. As far as villain ideas to eliminate the heroes goes, stopping time and shooting us point blank, it's up there. It's up there with the really good ideas.
You should consider this an honor. Let's see. I think I'll start with the smart-mouthed little brat first.
Who are you calling smart-mouthed?
Perhaps I'll save the intelligent girl for last. Now what was that you were saying about authority? You could plead for your lives. It might help, but I doubt it.
To you? Yeah, right!
Keep your filthy hands off. What's that? Keep your filthy hands off of Estelle. Don't you harm a single hair on her head, or I'll use every technique I know to cut your miserable carcass to pieces.
Joshua!
Joshua? Yeah, that was a little intense, dude.
You certainly talk big for someone who can't even wiggle his fingers. Fine, I'll start with you!
Stop! I'll never let you get away with hurting him!
Joshua, I don't think we've ever seen Joshua make that face before.
Die.
No!
What the heck? What?
That light.
Damn it. If I could just reach my camera.
Is that the thing we got in the parcel?
What's going on?
I can move again.
Estelle, what was that black light?
I don't know, but I think it came from that ornament Dad sent us.
Impossible! My family heirloom, my artifact, it's broken!
It hardly matters, since you played your last hand. It's time to face reality.
Yeah! I can't believe you'd really stoop this low!
It's disgusting. I will not be taken in.
Ah!
After him.
Okay.
A little bit of dungeon crawling?
Hey, wait up! I can't let a story like this get away!
Oh my. I believe I've lost a few years off of what little remains to me.
My lord, are you all right, my lord?
Oh, monsters. Monsters.
A cell? Oh, that's where he was keeping his pets, I guess. And an elevator? Nile, this guy. Okay. A boat chase.
Hey, what's that? It's Maya Dolmo's yacht. Hey, wait!
We can go after him in this boat. Come on, you two. Get on board.
All right.
Oh, sorry, Niall.
Hey, let me come too!
Dude, you would majorly slow us down. Ruan North Block. Oh, these guys are about to get a show.
Whoa! Ah!
There he goes. And here we come. Dude, this boat chase. Dude, Dalmor, just give it up. All right, we're closing in. This craft is small and lightweight, so we have the edge, it seems. Oh, right, he does still have that. Damn stubborn little. Take this. Oh, wow. Hi-ya. What? Ha, that'll teach you not to underestimate a bracer. Joshua, flank him on the right. Roger that. Huh? Whoa, how'd he get so fast? The wind is blowing toward open water. It's catching his sails and giving him a boost. Not good. At this rate, the yacht has a clear advantage. We won't be able to catch up. Say what now? It looks like Adio smiles on me today. I bid you farewell, brats. I don't know why Adios would smile on you. You've gotta be kidding! We were so close! He's gonna get away. There must be something we can do. What the? They're here. Did Chloe call? Who the heck? Who did Chloe call? All right, getting away is all well and good, but what now? I guess I have no choice but to head for the Empire. Or, if I lie low for a while, maybe he... Are these the... No, those aren't the... Who are they? Is that the Calvert Crest? What? Okay, no, this is hero music, so they're not. He's not about to get bombed in the water or anything like that. What? Ugh! I think that's the Calvert Republic? Or one of the places we haven't been to? Maybe Grancel? What's this airship? Is it the Royal Army? No, the coat of arms is wrong. It's the Royal Guard ship, a high-speed cruiser. Her name is the Arseille. Oh, so this is, Richard? Female officer? No, I don't know who these jokers are at all. Well, well, looks like we got here just in time. That blue and white uniform! Are you Her Majesty's Royal Guard? Precisely. I am the company commander, Julia Schwartz. Okay. Mayor Morris Dalmor of Ruan, I'm placing you under arrest for arson, robbery, and embezzlement, among other charges. This is a dream. It has to be! No. Did he pass out? Okay. Huh. I wonder if Schwarz has any relation to Schwarzer. What's going on? Jean called the Royal Army for reinforcements. But how'd they get here so fast? Oh there, bracers. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated. Please, let us handle this matter. I pressed Mayor Dalmor for information once he regained consciousness, but... he apparently can't remember anything regarding the past few hours very well, if he remembers them at all. He's also drawing a complete blank about the arson and robbery. Really? Kinda like the leader of the Sky Bandits. Oh! Wait, he was under control that whole time? Gilbert probably wasn't. I imagine Gilbert was not. Maybe it's related to those men in black from before. Well, even if he can't remember, the crimes are pretty clear-cut. It should go without saying that we'll be checking out his steward, too. If we uncover anything, we'll be sure to let the Bracer Guild know. We appreciate it. By the way, Lieutenant, I have a favor to ask. What might that be? Would it be at all possible for me to get on board that ship as well? It's supposed to be the most advanced airship to ever come out of Zeiss. It'd make for a great story, and I really need one. I'm afraid not. The Arseille was only just completed and is still undergoing flight testing. I must ask that you not comment on her at all until she's officially unveiled. So Chloe has enough clout to get them to use something completely unveiled to the world to help us stop Mayor Dalmor. Who is Chloe Rins? What? Oh, come on! You've got to at least give me something about the mayor and his steward being arrested. Don't worry, the facts of the story will be given over to the Royal News Agency. Until then, please refrain from reporting any of this. I honestly do feel like Niall got the short end of the stick, because he did help out a lot towards the end with making sure our proof was more solid. What choice do I have? Alright, I can do this. I can write a story with even the barest scrap of info. I've got to hurry back to the agency and put these events to paper. If you'll pardon me, everyone. Well, he's in his usual high spirits. Would you expect any less? I'm told that the liberal news circulation has increased dramatically of late. I hope he's not planning to write a big propaganda piece. What do you mean? Never mind. That was quite impressive, First Lieutenant Schwarz. And yep, here's Colonel Richard and the lady whose name I have a lot of trouble remembering. Colonel! Whoa! Colonel Richard. Oh, I remember you. I presume that you were the new bracers this guild spoke of. Oh, so you were the one Jean got in touch with, Colonel Richard? Yes, I received word at Layston Fortress where the Royal Forces are stationed. I got here as quickly as I could, only to find that the crisis had passed. Excellent work, Lieutenant. That's very kind of you, sir. Still, I wonder, what would bring the guards from the Royal City here, and so quickly? Perhaps you know of a route so secret that even our intelligence division is unaware of it? Surely you jest. Come now, Captain, this is hardly a time to pick a fight. I was simply admiring the proactive stance of the Royal Guardsmen. It's good to have you on our side. If it please you, Lieutenant, we'll take over the investigation from here and move matters to the Layston Fortress. I believe the mayor will be well attended to there. Yes, sir, I understand. Now, if you'll excuse us. Ladies and gentlemen of the Bracer Guild and Royal Guard, and the young lady in uniform. Fate willing, I think we shall see each other again. And with that, I bid you farewell. Safe travels, everyone. So, are we gonna grill Kloe on this now? Because it doesn't make sense how they arrived otherwise. Maybe I'm just imagining things? But did the Colonel look like he was eyeballing Kloe to anyone else? Was he? I'm sure it's just because he doesn't see students very often in his line of work. I wouldn't make too much of it.
I'll bet you're right. That's probably it. That's not the impression I got at all.
I'm certain that he's just as surprised as you are. It's hard to believe that Bracer so young would be so capable. He might be scouting out you out to become part of the Royal Guard.
Oh, come on, don't flatter us. We had a lot of help on this case.
You needn't be so modest. You're not full-fledged Bracers yet, but I presume that you wish to become so.
Well, yes, we're in training for it.
We intend to travel all over the country before the Queen's birthday celebration as part of our preparations.
I see. You're partaking in self-study, then.
Lieutenant Schwarz, everything is ready for the CO's departure.
Acknowledged. Estelle and Joshua, and Chloe too, of course. We must be leaving soon. I hope that our paths will cross again.
Yes, ma'am.
We'll be looking forward to it.
Thank you very much. Uh-oh, that sounded a little heartfelt, Kloe. Oh, wow, that's a full retinue.
Regiment, attention!
Whoa.
Royal Guardsman Warship Arseille, prepare for takeoff.
That salute, though. So they're from Zeiss. We're probably headed to Zeiss next. Gransel will be... I'm assuming there's going to be some secret other dimension final dungeon, so it'll be Zeiss, Gransel, and then wherever the heck we're headed last.
Wow, a salute and fanfare to go with it? That's a little overwhelming.
Yeah, and a state-of-the-art ship to boot. How long has Sieg been there? But I guess you'd expect as much from the defenders of Her Majesty the Queen.
True.
Oh, I think I get it now. Chloe's planning on going into the Royal Guards, Royal Guardsmen once she graduates.
Lieutenant Schwarz sure is cool, though. She kind of reminds me of that character that Chloe played, Oscar the Knight. I think so too. What an odd coincidence. Scream!
Ruan Bracer Guild.
Oh, don't tell me the Royal Guardsman showed up! And that Arseille was there too? She's supposed to be cutting edge. It's too bad I just worked the info desk. I'd have liked to see that.
I never figured you for the military enthusiast. Still, didn't you end up speaking to Colonel Richard?
Yes, he was on duty at Layston HQ. I don't know how the Royal Guardsmen got there so quickly, though. I guess there's a lot more cross-communication in the military than I thought.
Amazing that they managed to communicate at all, given how many agencies there are. Regular Army, Border Patrol, Intelligence, the Royal Guard. It must be pretty complicated.
Cleaning up after an incident like this will be a major undertaking. What will happen to the administration of Ruan from now on?
There is kind of a vacuum, and the whole I was mind-controlled defense might not go over so well.
Huh.
Dunon?
Dunon's the only person who it really makes sense for. Yeah, since the mayor's been arrested, I'll imagine they'll be sending someone in as acting mayor. And if Dalmore is found guilty, elections will have to be held. Plus, reparations will probably be made toward the orphanage.
Really? Thank goodness. All of this is thanks to Estelle and Joshua. Thank you so much. Truly.
Come on, you don't have to be so formal.
We just did what was right. Plus, it wasn't just us. Agate played a big part.
Speaking of... Gene, have you received any word from him?
Yes, but unfortunately, I'm afraid he wasn't able to capture the men in the black uniforms. They were not alone, apparently. Agate was ambushed.
What?
Is he all right?
Yes, he managed to defeat them. I believe he gave chase, and they're on their way to Zeiss. By now, he's probably well outside of Ruan.
Wow! Talk about hardcore!
Well, he's got plenty of experience after all. He'd been chasing those black-clad characters for a while. I think they're related to a job your father asked him to do.
Dad asked him?
Yeah, actually, what a left turn! Who knew that old dad had machinations in play?
And Agate just did what he asked?
Well, the one to put Agate out of the Ravens in his place was none other than Cassius himself. Oh, the one to put Agate of the Ravens in his place. Oh, okay, he put Agate in his place. I get it. And whatever you might like to claim, Agate stood no chance against him.
Whoa, seriously?
Cassius really beat some sense into him, and Agate's too stubborn to simply say thanks and leave it at that.
Ah, I get it. Maybe that's why he's so abrasive when it comes to us.
Abrasive barely covers that guy's attitude. Guess he's not so high and mighty when where Dad's involved, huh?
Oh, speaking of your father...
Something wrong?
What about that black augment that lit up and saved our lives at the mayor's estate?
Oh yeah, that's right! So much has been going on that I forgot all about it. I wonder what that was all about.
That augment may have saved our skins, but it was still weird.
An unusually colored augment, huh? What can you tell me about it?
Well...
Estelle explained that it, along with a memo, had been in a package addressed to Cassius.
Oh my, that's quite a story.
From Kay, asking about a Professor R. Could it be?
You know what it means?
Not specifically. I've got a hunch, but nothing to back it up. But if you want to know more about its origin, I'd suggest going to Zeiss.
Why Zeiss?
As you should know, Zeiss is famous for the manufacture of augments. There must be someone there who might know something about your augment.
Makes sense. We may never learn more about the black augment without consulting an expert.
But we still have more training here to finish!
Well, about that, you may want to prepare yourselves. Received recommendation!
What?
Really?
You had to have seen this coming. I mean, you got a recommendation from Bose after the Sky Bandit incident. Given your crucial roles in all the cases recently,
I see no reason not to award it. Your assessment and reward have been prepared. Received payment for festival help! Okay, no extra BP, yeah, I saw that coming. Junior Bracer 4th class, Teresa the target. 10 BP! Junior Bracer 4th class still! Wow, all this on top of the pay for performing in the campus festival? Thank you for everything you've done for us. Come on, you've earned it. I confess, I'd also like to see you advance as quickly as possible. I believe we'll be able to make the best use of your talents this way.
Thank you, Jean.
We'll do our best to live up to your expectations.
Congratulations, both of you. It'll be kind of lonely here without you, though. Chloe.
Yeah, you're right. It'll be tough to say goodbye. Trust me, Chloe, if I could, I'd keep you in the party, but we have a new male-female pair we gotta meet in Zeiss and add to our party, and I'm sure they'll be just as cool as you.
Oh, please don't mind me. I'm just being selfish. Will you please tell me when you find out what day you're leaving? I'd like to see you off, at least as far as the Air-Letten checkpoint.
Okay, no opportunity to do any stuff after the... Oh, it's over! Chapter 2, Madrigal of the White Magnolia. I think I have the misplaced in the actual title, so I'm probably gonna have to change that. We are going to save off where this is at. Let's do it here.
All right.
So now we're in between chapters 2 and 3.
Oh, Agate's chase.
Stubborn bastard.
Hey.
How the heck is he keeping up with such a huge sword?
My training. Oh, that's way too fast. I hope you guys could read that.
Damn, we can't shake him.
We have no choice. Time to counterattack.
I guess you're finally taking me seriously. Good. I was getting sick of playing tag with you fools. He's not gonna give up until he's dead.
What a stubborn idiot. Does he really think he can beat 2-1 odds?
I think I already have.
What?
Every fight takes spirit. You lose that, you've lost everything. And I figured out exactly what kind of spirit you losers had when you took off with your tails between your legs.
Silence, Gilder dog! We can handle you. You're in for a painful death!
Nope.
Damn it! We can't get caught now!
Okay, how about you just surrender and give me your full confessions? Starting with who you are and what you're after.
You needn't concern yourself about that.
Silver-haired guy!
What?
No, still not him.
When did you get here?
Commander! You came for us!
You two are pitiful. You failed to report in as appointed, and this is why?
We have no excuses. We've had a lot of interference.
I get it. So you're the man in charge.
Only of this particular scene. Allow me to apologize on behalf of my men. Could I persuade you to overlook this incident?
No. No, you really couldn't.
Huh? Okay, repeat that.
I said that I'd like for you to overlook this incident. We never had any intention of running afoul of the Bracer Guild.
Don't make me laugh. You think I'm just gonna look the other way and let you get away with what you did?
Well, I had thought it a generous offer personally. Certainly a fairer price than death. Both of you, stand down. Return to the rendezvous point at once.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Commander.
Where do you think you're going? Son of a... Fine. The target may have changed, but as long as I have one, and you being the leader, I assume you've got better information to offer me than your underlings anyway.
Huh. You think it'll be that easy to make me talk?
I sure as hell intend to find out.
Oh. This battle music, though.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
You have an irrepressible passion, but a great weight bears down upon you. You are not
quite so different from me.
What did you just say?
It's a painful thing to be powerless in a time of crisis, but you know that feeling all too well, no? I can see it in your eyes.
Fine then. I don't know who you are, but I think I like you.
There is no shame in powerlessness. There is no shame in being outmatched. You and I both know that. Perhaps we could come to a mutually beneficial arrangement?
Screw you! Don't act like you know anything about me! You're in for one hell of a beatdown!
Oh!
And Agate goes down.
Oh!
All talk, no shock. Bet the guild's gonna love interrogating you.
Oh!
What the? Is that the body split craft?
Agate sensed something faint from the dark forest beyond.
Nice try, but you've got a heavy heart. And a heavy heart makes for a light blade.
Why don't you come out from hiding and say that?
When a warrior enters a skirmish, he must be prepared to lose everything. Otherwise, he can gain nothing. In order to live as a man, you must forego all anger and grief. With that, I bid you farewell.
The presence in the trees seemed to have vanished. He played Agate for a total joke, dude.
Forego? How the hell am I supposed to do that?
Dang, dude. Agate and... Oh, Chapter 3, The Black Orbment. The Legend of Heroes trails in the sky. Ruan North Block. Huh. So Agate's got a heavy heart for some reason.
Guess she's not here yet. Did we get here that early?
Could be. Want to kill some time at the tavern?
Nah, it's nice out, so I think I'd rather just wait here. I doubt I could ever get tired of the view from the river.
Yeah, no kidding.
I even get the feeling that Ruan's finally back to normal. Pretty amazing considering the uproar after Mayor Dalmore's arrest.
Well, a seated mayor has never been arrested before. Try to imagine if Mayor Klaus was arrested in R'lent.
Yeah, that would be a real shock. But when I think of it that way, the people of Ruan almost seem cold. I mean, they were clearly surprised by what happened, but not a single person was truly shocked, far as I can tell.
Well, you have to remember, the mayor of Ruan has always been selected by bloodline alone. He wasn't elected to his position by the Ruanians, and that probably makes all the difference in the world.
Yeah, that's true. The people of R'lent appointed Klaus mayor because they liked him and trusted him. Dalmor's getting what he deserves, but I still feel kind of bad for him.
Yeah, and initially, I was under the impression that the Dalmor who offered Matron Teresa his place and that very nice place they could stay while the orphanage was burned down was his real self. And then he was being mind controlled for all the other stuff. But that cage and the monsters that were in that cage didn't come out of nowhere, so Dalmor's a bit of a weirdo.
Hey, look who's here.
Huh?
And this is Sieg.
Oh, Sieg. Estelle, Joshua. Hey, I'm sorry, but I'm late.
No problem. We just got here ourselves.
Don't tell us you ran all the way here. You really didn't need to rush. I couldn't let you two go without seeing you off. Thank you very much for contacting me. Chloe, I keep telling you don't have to thank us. You too, Sieg. Thanks for coming.
Well then, shall we be off?
Okay. We need to use the south exit to reach Zeiss, right?
Yes, on the southern road is a checkpoint called Air-Letten. You can set out for Zeiss from there.
Roger that. Okay, let's go.
Okay, Chloe's in our party, and she's still second. That's a little weird. But I guess we haven't really had control of our party since, there hasn't been a point in time where we were in control of, just...
No, we totally were.
F it, I don't know how it works.
I've been working here for a long time, but... What should I do about my pay?
Yeah, that's the first question I'd be asking too, because... I'm sure Dalmor's estate has it in place to keep paying people.
Who would have believed that the mayor would be arrested? What's to become of this estate now? I've gotten wrapped up in this whole mess. I think that Dario and I are going to leave soon and go find new jobs. Maybe I should become a guide?
The Sapphire Glim is still there, which I guess is kind of okay. But...
Oh well.
Let's go. We're going to take a quick visit up to his secret animal dungeon. Dario's still standing outside.
I've served House Dalmor for over 30 years. That's such a distinguished family with a long history of dedicated service to Ruan should come to this.
Yeah. It's kind of weird for you not to notice, Dario. But we're not going to delve too much into that. So these are his sleeping quarters. Nothing secret here, I guess. Oh, well. Nothing in here. Except the chains. Nothing there. Hmm. There's a drawbridge control unit here. That's where the drawbridge control is at? So Mayor Dalmor was in charge of that this whole time? I find that a little weird, but oh well. Nothing. We can go this entire route, but there's nothing hidden, nothing like secretly hidden here. Huh. Oh well. I feel better for at least having explored it. So now we can leave this place with nothing heavy in our hearts, unlike some heavy blades I could name. No, first we have to check the guild. First we're checking the guild, because I know right after the whole Relent business ended, there was one more request that we had to fulfill in Bose. Where you at? That's the Granite Orbal Factory, Ruan Bracer Guild. Nope, that's everything.
Oh, hey you guys. Karna!
Are you feeling better?
Fit as a fiddle. I'm back at work as of today.
I wish I had some way to pay you back for all the trouble I put you through.
Oh, come on!
Once you become full-fledged bracers, come back to Ruan.
I'll be waiting for you.
What's upstairs?
Melvin, the mayor's been arrested. I just don't... What's going on?
No new jobs at all, huh?
Oh, freaking well.
Is there anyone else here? The Longinus at the church?
No. No one else that we really hung out with. At least no one that immediately comes to mind.
And then, which way is Zeiss? Orion Causeway, I think it was, we had to go down.
Alright, so down the Orion Causeway we go. Air-Letten checkpoint, yep. And I've already fought pretty much everything here. So this is just going to be a straight shot down. And then we'll see new monsters as soon as we're on the other side of Air-Letten. I'm looking forward to that.
Fango and Bronco.
I think Fango and Bronco were very similar to the things we fought, the fourth boss, the fourth Trails of Cold Steel boss. Very similar to those.
Air-Letten gets a whole new scene, I guess.
I've been here before, but this is a nice little spot. The view here is breathtaking. Certainly doesn't feel like a checkpoint, that's for sure.
Actually, I hear that a lot of visitors come here to see the waterfall.
Really? Ruan sure has a lot of nice places, huh? I can understand why the Duke would want to live here.
Agreed. But I think R'lent is also a nice, relaxing place to live.
Oh, you've been to R'lent?
Yes, I've been to all 5 of the great cities.
Oh, that's right. Zeiss is up ahead.
You'll be surprised how charming it is.
Really? Zeiss is the really technologically advanced one, I remember that. Sounds like we're in for some fun.
Alright, why don't we get the paperwork started then?
Okay.
And then Kloe might crash here with us for the night, she might not.
Is there anyone? What do you have for us? Shop.
Briny Delight. We've already learned Briny Delight, yeah.
We haven't learned the vegetable sandwich recipe? Huh.
I guess because it heals so little.
Hey, you're back. Thanks for what you did before. What brings you here today?
Feel free to stop in whenever you have time to spare.
We don't need to rest. Hey, welcome. This is an inn specifically for travelers. If you need me for anything, just give me a shout.
Okay, Orta, I'll remember that.
Good afternoon. How may I be of assistance?
We were wondering what had to be done to obtain permission to enter Zeiss.
Okay then. Step right up. I'll take care of you. Be aware, though, that once these procedures have begun, you will not be allowed to leave the checkpoint.
Are you okay with that?
Okay, so this is a point of no return, but we checked. We did everything.
Yeah, we did everything, so hey.
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Then please start by signing these documents. Estelle and Joshua signed their names to the documents.
Alright, everything looks to be in order.
Is the young lady there not joining you?
Can you not see that Gina's Royal Academy uniform? No, she's not going to be joining us.
Oh, I only came to see them off.
Ah, very well then.
You'll be able to accompany them as far as the mouth of the Caldea Tunnel.
Thank you very much.
What's the Caldea Tunnel?
It's the main road that joins this checkpoint to Zeiss. The path is a long tunnel that passes directly through Caldea Hill.
Wow, an underground road!
That'll definitely be a first for me too.
Okay, no scene here, we're just heading out. Oh, not that way though. Let's talk to this joker first though.
Oh, hello again.
hello again rather.
I'm still in your debt for your actions when His Excellency the Duke arrived.
Thanks to you, he's not causing any more trouble for the other customers.
Though, I still have doubts, I'd be happy to cooperate with the Bracer Guild in the future.
If anything else comes up, I hope you'll be willing to help.
Of course. Of course we will, Han. We're not just gonna hang you out to dry, bro.
That's what bracers are for.
Yeah, they're seriously treating us like we haven't been here before. I like the view of the waterfall, though. Cannot lie. It's beautiful. Wow, this is amazing! Huh, so the waterfall comes from a man-made river.
I think it's called the Lhotse Waterway. It was made a very long time ago.
Yes, and it's linked directly to the Valeria Lakeshore.
Pretty impressive, given that they did it without any ornaments to help.
So, what's that over there?
Oh, the tunnel that looks really ominous and foreboding.
That's the entrance to the tunnel, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, our parting.
So I guess this is goodbye.
Yes.
So, you're going to be traveling around the kingdom, right? We might be able to meet again in Gronsal.
Really?
I'll be going back there when this queen's birthday celebration starts. Some of my relatives will be there, so I have to join them.
That's just a month away, isn't it? I think we may actually be in Gransel around that time.
So then, once you're done with your family stuff, contact the Gransel Guild branch. If you do, we can try to meet up.
I certainly will. Estelle and Joshua, I can't thank you enough. I won't ever forget everything that you've done for me.
Come on, don't be so formal.
We're in your debt as well, for many reasons. I'd say we're pretty even.
What a thing to say. When
we confronted the mayor, I said some terrible things. You care for no one but yourself. But I was no different.
Huh?
I've been running away from the reality of my own situation for a while now. To the orphanage, and to the academy. But the two of you taught me something. You helped me find the courage to hold my head high, and find the strength to protect what matters. Because of you, I know how to be brave. I don't really get it, but if we were able to help you, I'm happy. Oh. Cheer up, okay? We'll see each other again in Grancel. Yes, absolutely.
Squirt?
And maybe we'll get to see Sieg there too, right? That was a joke. I mean, Grancel's pretty far away. I don't think those wings would hold. Besides, your home is here. Sieg isn't just any bird, you know. I think he'll be there. I'm sure.
Sieg's just full of surprises, isn't he? Well then, shall we be off?
Yeah. Hey, good luck to both of you on your journey. And I'll be praying for you to find your father.
Thank you.
You two take care.
Uh-oh, Chloe's last words.
Yes, I think so too. We'll see them again.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Chloe. Schwarz called it.
Miss Julia, you're done with your duties at Layston Fortress?
Yes, it took longer than I had anticipated. Pardon my rudeness, but I've come to get your report on the incident.
Her report? Thank you for your service.
Is Chloe part of the royal family?
Hey now, settle down, Sieg. Have you been fulfilling your duty as an escort?
Uh-oh.
He's always been very helpful. Isn't that right, Sieg?
He's certainly chipper. The Arseille is stopped at the end of the highway. You're to report in there.
Understood. I'll be leaving school for a while. I need to say goodbye to my teachers before returning to Grancel. Estelle, Joshua, I'll take what you taught me and show you that I can be strong. Stronger than even you two. I'll do everything in my power to see to that.
So Chloe's last name is Rins and not Von Arlesny or Von Arlees. Von Osleys. It's not Von Osleys, so she might not be royalty. She must be training to be a real guardsman. That's the only thing that makes sense. But oh well. Oh well, we'll find out exactly what her deal is.
Huh?
What's wrong?
Nothing. I just got the feeling that someone was coming.
Huh. There's someone in here other than us?
No, there's not.
Guess not.
Yeah. Sorry, must have imagined it.
Oh, I get it. I think you still got a little crush on Chloe.
Huh? What makes you say that?
Oh, don't be shy. You know I can read you like a book. It's not unreasonable after all. You did, kiss her during the play. What if she asked you to come back? You'd say yes, right?
I guess you didn't notice then.
Huh? Notice what?
The last scene. That was just for show, you know. It was staged, just so it would look like a real kiss for the audience.
Huh? What?
You really can be completely clueless sometimes. It was written right there in the script notes.
Oh, I see. Note to self, do not insert foot into mouth. But why do I feel so relieved?
Estelle? You okay?
I'm fine! Come on, Zeiss awaits! I honestly thought it was a real kiss too. And it looks like Joshua even stood on his tippy toes to reach. Oh, what is that? a rock turtle or something, like a Cabracon. It's probably highly jet tortoise. Okay, we want to use fire and wind against it. A reptilian monster that likes warm places uses earth-based arts weak against wind. Yeah, I thought it was going to be pretty weak to, or pretty strong against physical attacks, but I guess not. Let's see how it likes an airstrike. Take some. Oh, about as much as it likes Joshua's attack. So let's have a dual strike happen then. I can't live like this. I really can't. I need to change this thing right freaking now. Oh my adios, dude. I cannot have Joshua's accuracy be a coin flip. Come on. We're changing him up right the F now. What can we change? Hold on. Blind. Crap, if we get rid of blind, we'll probably lose a lot of stuff. Please. EP cut. Oh, Scent will give him even more stuff, but... Dexterity plus 5. Dexterity plus 10. I am so sorry, Joshua. You need this really badly, bro. Airstrike. Okay, so we're pretty much there. Can't... Okay, but at least the hit too. Like, it costs more for him to cast arts now. But oh my adios, dude. I cannot stand to see him miss one more time. I swear to you all, dude. Wait. No, dexterity's right. Dexterity's right. I think. I'm fairly certain it was dexterity. Oh, what are you? Looks like a manatee or something. Cave ray or a manta ray. Wow, that efficacy to fire and wind. A monster living in the dank underground, fast and armed with poisonous fins, so it can inflict poison. Let's test this out. Oh, right. Okay, let's test this out this way then. Look at that delicious dexterity. Right. Oh, I never showed off their new equipment. I probably should have done that before Kloe left our party. So Joshua, he's got a shield vest and double spikes now. Still with the skull daggers. He didn't change too much. Estelle, she got a hex stave because she was still using the pile rod. Or the birch staff? Yeah, she was still using the birch staff. And I also gave her the gladiator headband. It drops her defense, but I want Estelle to be physically powerful too. Found death blow too. Reduced the searching empty chests. That's really sad. You never know. But we're racking up these death blow twos though. That's pretty cool. Which way did I come in? Oh, Zeiss is that away. That's the Air-Letten checkpoint. So let's double back just a little tiny bit and check what's in the nooks and crannies back here before we continue on. Ooh. Looks like not a Caterpie, but more like that Monster Rancher monster. The larva thing. I forget what it's called. Damp crawler. A larva monster living in the darkness spews sticky fluid to weaken its prey. Let's just attack. Yeah, basic attack madness should carry us through this fight too. Oh, Estelle. It's okay. I forgive you, Estelle. I forgive you instantly. Dual strike. Freaking dead, exactly what we want to see. Actually getting some respectable experience points from these jokers. I'm okay with that. Cool. Found Curia Balm. The chest is empty because you removed the contents, you looter. Maybe whoever's leaving these around is to blame rather than us. Found Tiro Balm. Nope. Still empty. I don't understand. Okay. Yeah, I think we've taken everything that's here. So now we can just continue on to Zeiss. We fought 3 new types of enemies, which is always interesting. Well, we didn't fight them. More like we massacred them. But you guys know what I mean. Because I just explained what I mean. Oh, what are you? Where's your face? I guess we got the part that wasn't its face. And then basic attack madness. Yep. She didn't miss. Golden. Wait, what is it? Actually, bubble blower. We want to use fire and wind against it. A crustacean monster living in the darkness breathes hypnotic bubbles. So, if these things had had a chance to act even once, we probably would have been contending with status ailments this whole time. Thankfully, they weren't able to move. Alright. Let's breathe in some of that good Zeiss air and see what's going on. Oh, there's another part to this. Makes sense. Oh, this is just a straight shot. Bridge. I'm assuming something is gonna happen here. No? Okay. Let's rest a second. And since they put a rest point here, that's making me extremely antsy. So let's also save. Let's save here. We're about to hit level 20, legit. Okay, another part to this. Wait, is Zeiss underground or something? Are they built into the hill? What? This is weird. Like, I don't think we should still be underground at this point. North Limestone Cave, warning beware of monsters. And we can go right around it, okay. Let's see what kind of monsters. Found Tira Balm. The chest is empty because you've already been here. But we haven't been inside that limestone cave, though. Chaldea Limestone Cave. Okay, and this is a dungeon proper. Ooh! What are these? They're probably obnoxiously strong. What are they weak to? Nothing much. Blue penguin. An excitable monster nesting in caves. It is skilled with water-based arts. Let's attack physically and see what that does. 180. Okay, so let's have a stealth physically attack also. 207? Okay, and now let's see what they're working with. Blue penguin is preparing to cast arts. Don't want that to happen. Okay, no, we're standing right in the middle of it. Diamond dust. Okay, this could be bad. Yeah, no, that's pretty bad. Because Estelle's probably about to die, so might as well use this before we lose it. Got him. Yeah, we're not going to fight another blue penguin. Oh, crap!
I'm sorry. Not now.
Wow, we're definitely not gonna let them just kill us like that. Okay, so we're gonna play this one a little differently. Let's Chaos Brand them both. And hopefully they don't resist them. Gotcha. And then Estelle, you also work your magic. Thankfully, we were able to up his accuracy without sacrificing any of his arts. That's what I was worried about, but fear's unfounded. Get him. And then Estelle will get in on the action too. Cool. Can we flicker? No. Not lined up. That is such a thin AoE. I mean, a thin lineup. Oh, crap. Okay, so Estelle will comment. No, she's not gonna do that. We can kill one of them. Let's get this guy. Oh, never mind. All Joshua has to do is hit him with a dual strike. Got him.
That's that thing. Let's move out.
58 experience points. Hold the phone. Now we have to fight this thing too. And these are probably red penguins or purple penguins? Pink penguin. And efficacy's a lot more HP though. An excitable monster nesting in caves will spontaneously sing to court a mate. So they're gonna call in reinforcements. I'm gonna have Joshua on no game status from the beginning then. Or I should probably just have cast Chaos Brand actually. Yeah, I should have cast Chaos Brand from the beginning. Okay. Joshua is gonna continue on attacking. And I don't think the other pink penguin's gonna be able to... Nah. He just ran away. Or she just ran away. Pink penguin is paralyzed with fear. Let's have Estelle start working on this one. Paralyzed with fear. They're about to do something outrageous. I know it. Come on, Joshua. And then Estelle will Chaos Brand hers again. Just to keep it complacent. Don't summon a mate. Don't summon a mate. We really need you not to summon a mate. Okay. That's not changing the whole paralyzed mating call. I'm not sure what that was, but I do know I don't want Joshua to get actually afflicted by it. Oh, Estelle, she can snipe it from over here with her comet. That's awesome. Okay, and Joshua can start making his way over here. Alright, Estelle will cast Chaos Brand again. We're just keeping this one complacent while we kill it. Cool. And then a Chaos Brand. We probably have to rotate the camera so we can actually see what's going on with this pink penguin. Yeah, no, I'm really glad I didn't find out what mating call does. That would have been bad. Strength plus 10? It's not gonna do anything, is it? Okay. We'll just beat on it while it doesn't know what's going on. Totally fair. Okay. I was gambling right there because I was like, I don't want to use her CP up. But if its mating call goes through, then we could potentially have this entire fight turned around against us. 58 experience points. Tender poultry. Actually, two more of those and Estelle would hit her next level. But, we're going to go ahead and call it a part here. Because we're going to make it to Zeiss. That's going to be next time. Join me then for more Trails in the Sky. Bye for now, guys.